the coolest part of this night was his family coming down next to the on-deck circle, and he had a moment with them. His teammates loved it. His family loved it. Great moment for Sabathia.
Now we take a look at the Toyota leaders. When you look at MLB history, 17 of the 9,653 pitchers in the history of this game have gotten to 3,000 strikeouts, 14 of them in the Hall of Fame. Curt Schilling, Roger Clemens, the two that are not. That's 0.18% of pitchers that have reached that milestone. For hitters, very similar. 0.19% of hitters that have reached 3,000 hits. 25 of those 32 are currently in the Hall of Fame. You know, John, this is not a number that necessarily was talked about as much as we hear 3,000 hits talked about, but it's been just as rare, even more rare, in the history of this game. Just an incredible milestone when you look at the scope of baseball history.
Yeah, I think that graphic puts it in great perspective, right? I mean, you think about 3,000 hits, automatic Hall of Famer. You don't think the same way about the 3,000 strikeouts. Maybe we should change our thinking about that. But if you're talking about Sabathia, he gets to 250 wins, over 3,000 strikeouts. In my opinion, he's a first ballot Hall of Famer.
It turned into a pitcher's duel for sure as we take a look at our stars of the game presented by Heineken. CC Sabathia goes the 5 1/3, allows just 5 hits, 2 runs, becomes the 17th player with 3,000 strikeouts. Zach Greinke, 7 2/3, allows just the 5 hits, the 1 run. Economical as well, 102 pitches to get through those 2 outs into the 8th inning. You know, a lot of times we do see this in the National League game, right, John? And this was just both pitchers locked in. Greinke obviously going deeper and the Arizona offense doing a little bit more.
I thought Jeff Nelson did a great job during the broadcast of breaking down Greinke, how he got ahead in counts early with his fastball